Generally, we all think of the ground beneath us as rock hard and unable to move, especially when said ground is composed of notoriously strong igneous rock types composed of solidified lava or magma such as granite. And for a spot in the interior of Japan, comprising the southern edifice of the active Mount Ontake volcano, this was the case for many thousands of years. That was until disaster struck on September 14, 1984. On that day, at 8:48 a.m. local time in the morning, stress building up on a buried strike slip fault line was released, triggering significant horizontal ground motion that then also caused a second fault line nearby to slip. A magnitude 6.8 earthquake had just been generated, and due to its absurdly shallow epicenter of a mere 2 kilometers or 1.2 miles below the surface, created absurdly intense ground shaking and significant damage in regional structures. This shaking caused the ground in some areas to temporarily accelerate to 70% the force of gravity, translating to 6.87 meters or 22.54 feet per second. Since it had rained 6 of the last 7 days on the surrounding hills and mountains, this was a recipe for disaster as the ground was already saturated with water and thus heavier than it would otherwise be during the 40 seconds of intense shaking. As a result, the ground began to move in dozens of locations simultaneously, commencing multiple large landslides. As multiple distant rumbles became audible, an even louder one began on the southern flank of the active Mount Ontake volcano, which had last erupted a mere 5 years prior. All of a sudden, a massive patch of land which was 1,170 meters long, 640 meters wide, and averaged 68 meters or 223 feet thick started to visibly move. In mere seconds, an entire ridge of the Ontake volcano vanished as a half a square kilometer swath of ground collapsed to the south-southeast, accelerating to speeds of 55.8 miles per hour or 89.8 kilometers per hour. In only 12 seconds' time, a 35 million cubic meter wall of rock started to run up and then quickly overtop a 100 meter or 328 foot high hill of the Komakaza Plateau. This landslide then divided into three prongs, dividing around Mount Komakaza and an additional ridge which also started burying and carving away at additional drainages. The main lobe of the rapidly advancing landslide then turned to the southwest, advancing down the Denjo River, burying much of the area in more than 50 meters or 164 feet thick of rock. 65 seconds in, this had sadly resulted in 5 fatalities, all of whom were mushroom hunters in moist dark patches of forest. 35 additional seconds later, further disaster struck as a recreational hot spring was obliterated, causing 4 more fatalities. The landslide then ran up and jumped over another ridge, merging with water and mud in the Nagori River, increasing the volume of the overall debris avalanche to 56 million cubic meters. At 2 minutes 20 seconds in, the first of 3 landslide lobes ceased its forward motion, by which time it had traveled 4.5 kilometers or 2.8 miles. More structures were hit 4 minutes in, and at 5 minutes 45 seconds in, the landslide diverted to the west, soon temporarily damming the Otaki River to form Lake Shizenko. The remains of submerged trees can still be seen today sticking out of this lake. The second lobe of the landslide ceased its forward motion at 6 minutes 32 seconds in, by which time it had traveled 10.3 kilometers or 6.4 miles. A lobe of the landslide advancing down the Otaki River briefly diverted to the south, but within 18 seconds the landslide stopped its forward motion. This landslide had traveled as much as 13.5 kilometers or 8.4 miles, causing in 1984 what would today be an inflation-adjusted damage of $271 million. In total, 7.87 square kilometers or 3.04 square miles of land had been buried in a layer of rock and mud which averaged 7.11 meters or 23.3 feet thick. So, why exactly did such a severe landslide occur? While not proven, one scientific paper noted that the collapse site likely experienced ground shaking of more than 2 times the force of gravity. To me, since the maximum ground acceleration was only 70% the force of gravity, it suggests that a form of amplification occurred. I suggest the amplification by a factor of 3 occurred due to the presence of a shallow hydrothermal system at 500 meters depth at Mount Ontake and a sizable magma chamber at 4 to 12 kilometers depth. These bodies of liquid slowed down the seismic waves, causing them to become amplified. This may be why the southern slope of the volcano, not above the epicenter of the earthquake, experienced the strongest ground shaking. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Mogus Kelki, for supporting this channel.